So here we have the Hyundai i20 1.4 SE automatic on an 18 plate. I'm going to start off by showing you around the outside of the car, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But from the outside, you can see it's a five-door car with alloy wheels. Let's start off inside the boot and then work our way around the rest of the car from there. So as we approach the back of the car, you'll see we have reversing sensors, plenty of boot space as well, along with that 60-40 split folding rear seat. Okay, so we're just going to work our way back round to the front of the car now, and then we'll hop in and run through some controls on the inside. But now that we've done a full circle of it, you can see it's in lovely condition the whole way round. Just briefly before we climb in, I think it's well worth seeing the interior from this exterior point of view. There's plenty to run through on the dashboard, so let's hop in and we'll do that right now. Okay, so now that we're inside the car, we're going to start with the dials. On the left-hand side, we have the rev counter, and on the right-hand side, the speedometer. In the middle, you can see the trip computer for the car, which includes a digital readout for the speedometer, the fuel gauge, the coolant temperature gauge, and at the very bottom, the total miles for this car, which are 14,262. If we back out to the steering wheel, on the left-hand side, we have stereo controls and phone controls, so the ability to answer and end phone calls, as well as having voice activation for your phone. And on the right-hand side, we've got cruise control and speed limiter. Over in the center is where you would pair your phone up, amongst other things. When it comes to music, you can see that we have DAB digital radio. This car's also got AM and FM as well. If you want to listen to your own music, you can do. You can do that via the Bluetooth audio, so you can stream your music wirelessly. Or you can plug in a USB or auxiliary device as well. Working our way down from there, we have the air conditioning. So you can determine where you'd like the air to be distributed, the fan speed, the temperature, and then that button turns the air conditioning on, it's on at the moment, or off. You can turn on your rear heated screen as well, and this button will recirculate the air that's already in the car. That's a great way of heating it up or cooling it down quickly, depending on the temperature you've set, of course. And you can turn that off just as easily. Underneath there, we have a 12-volt charging socket, and the auxiliary and USB input that I mentioned previously, and then the fully automatic gearbox, and then finally this button will turn off or turn on the parking sensors. All that leaves me to say is thank you for taking the time to watch this video. If you'd like to come and see the car in person and have a test drive, please feel free to call any of our MJA sites. We'd love to hear from you soon.